She is the chairman of the science class.
Chairman of the class of science class.
Hello Asli, hello
Paulina,
Paulin Tandianto.
Yeah.
Hello Cheryl.
Cheryl. Cheryl, can you hear my voice? I'm going to check my mic.
Of course.
Thank you. I'm happy to hear that. Okay. Gerarda, Imelda, Sinaga, welcome. Grace. Welcome. And would you please to inform your friends by WA to join us so that we do not waste a lot of time?
We are waiting for you to join so that we can begin our lesson in 5 minutes.
Langsung ya.
While we are waiting your friends, I'd like to remind you to be punctual because I know some of your friends are using, what is that, quota, yeah? So not all of them using Wi-Fi. So I think we should empathize. Those who cannot access internet quite easy by joining the class on time. Oh, welcome! I'm Bodias. Some of the students are joining our class today.
Yeah, Gerarda. And what else? Who else?
There are about 20 students.
22 students.
We are still waiting because we will begin our lessons in a few minutes. Few minutes ahead. Okay. So while we are waiting for your friends to join, once again, I'd like to remind you to prepare your pencil, your paper, your ballpoint. Maybe you want to take notes, or I'm sure that you will need that because we will have We will have a kind of quick answer game, something like that. So you only have
and also the quiz.
A few seconds to answer my question.
And also the quiz at the end of the lesson.
Yes, that's right.
Hi, Francisca, welcome.
Francisca
Aprilianti. Okay. I do not teach her. Maybe you, ma'am.
Yes. She's in 10th grade. And everyone who responds actively in this class will get extra score. So every time you ask question, every time you answer or respond my questions quickly, you will get extra score because your active participation is much appreciated here.
And don't forget, ma'am, for the students who are here, please inform your friends to join us soon. Therefore, we do not waste a lot of time. Please send WhatsApp to your friend and tell them that we are going to start soon. Patricia, Evelyn, maybe she is kicked from the forum.
If you cannot join from this GMeet, you can join us live streamingly.
YouTube channel.
So you can follow us and you are still able to join our class or giving response to Ma'am Indri's question in live chat.
So we are waiting for you.
This is gonna be interesting, Ma'am Tia.
42 students, Ma'am Indri.
More students are
and
joining
we have
us.
More 45 now. And I'm still waiting for the students who are going to join in the YouTube. And please prepare the pencil, the pen, and also the paper. Who knows that you are going to write something from Ma'am Indri's explanation.
Once again, everyone who actively participate in this lesson will get extra score. How can we know that? when you answer my questions, when you ask questions, I will record your student number and your name.
Maybe this is because of the time, ma'am. This is 11.
Oh yeah, right.
15. So 16. They have just closed the previous class, and it is the beginning of the class.
That's right. So could we just with you more minutes?
Because yeah, I think because we have to wait.
Still trying to join us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I see that the numbers of the students joining our class. Increasing.
Hi Grace, welcome.
Welcome Grace, welcome. Mm-hmm. Welcome Patricia. Oh, thank you.
Patricia.
You're punctual. You're coming to our class on time.
That's right. And you have to know that today we have 8 classes at once. Jadi ada 8 kelas ya hari ini ya. It is very crowded and fun, yeah.
Okay.
We have 71, 72. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yes. Yeah. So be involved. Jadi bisa ini masih dalam posisi mengkondisikan rekan-rekan teman-teman kalian. Sehingga bisa join dengan kelas.
Yeah, as soon as you join our class, then we are going to start. Yeah. Already 87, 89.
80.
Maybe they have already finished with the previous material. That's Hi, Suster Yeti, welcome.
Hello, Suster Yeti, welcome.
Good afternoon, Suster.
Hello, sorry. For being late.
Nice to meet you.
Afternoon, everyone. Good noon, ya. Good morning.
Yeah.
I think still morning, ha. Not yet 12 o'clock. So still good morning.
Yeah. Oh yeah, still.
Aku akan continue.
We are still trying to make the student join us because they had already finished the first, the previous class.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So how many of them supposed to be?
At classes
we have seen
200
difference means minus 3 of us. It means about 97 students are in the GMIT, and then the rest of them will be in YouTube channel.
And it is for 8 classes.
Yes,
it is for 8 classes.
So it means more than 200.
Yes, more than 200.
Okay, so we still wait for another students to enter, huh?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Maybe Ma'am Indri can louder your voice.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
So
yeah. Okay.
For the mic.
Thank you, sister.
Yeah.
About this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It is already 100. Maybe for the other student, you can join us by YouTube. So you have to join us by YouTube.
Yes, because maximum participants for the GMIT, I think 100.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then the rest of you will be able to join us via
YouTube.
Stage Squad's YouTube channel.
Would you please to inform your friends to join by YouTube? Because the GMIT is already.
Okay. While you are waiting for your friends to join, I'd like once again to inform you that your active participation will be recorded. I mean, if you ask questions or if you answer my questions, you can write your name, your student number, and class. And every active participation will get extra score.
Okay, good, I think. So just be attention on the live chat because we are going to have your answer there. We are going to check your answer there. So if you have the answer or the question, you can use the live chat.
Yeah, Jadi yang nanti aktif bertanya atau aktif menjawab nanti akan mendapatkan score. Dan jangan lupa menuliskan nama, kemudian kelas, dan juga nomor lisensi supaya Mem Indri bisa merekam siapa-siapa yang sudah aktif berpartisipasi. Oke. Okay, what about that, Miss
Jo? I write on the chat that the limit is limited to 100, so yes. I would like the students to inform your friends to join by this YouTube channel.
Okay, what about the participants?
We have 9 watching now. We should have more than that. 13. Yes. It's greater now. Okay. We are going to wait.
Silakan diinformasikan juga. Please inform to your friends in the class. Teman-teman di kelas, kalau tidak bisa join di Jimmy, baik kalian di better join us in YouTube channel that I have shared you last night, so that you are able to join in live chat. Jadi sayang ya kalau misalnya nggak bisa join, nanti nggak tahu akan ada apa, akan ada exercise menarik apa, lama.
This is the
big. Tapi nggak dapat extra score. You won't be able to get extra score.
This is the first material, ma'am. So it is the beginning of the next KD. So I think it is very important. Yeah, don't miss it.
Shall we begin?
100. No, ma'am. I think we have to wait for about 3 minutes or 5 minutes.
Okay.
I'm going to ask the other student by WhatsApp.
So we're still to inform you a bit about what we're doing. Jadi saya akan memberitahukan sedikit.
Give the description, Give the description.
Apa sih yang akan dipelajari? What materials or what lessons that we will learn today? Well, it is very important for you to be able to describe some important object in our university. Materi itu berhubungan dengan segala sesuatu untuk menggambarkan objek atau tempat. And the materials is related to everything to describe an object or a place. This is what we call descriptive text. And then if you want to know what is descriptive text, ma'am, I will explain to you later. And then you will also try to do or try to practice the language yourself. Okay. So that's why Ma'am Indri asked you to prepare paper, pencil, and ballpoints, because this is very important if you want to take notes. Kalau mau catat-catat, kalian bisa melakukan. You can do.
Yeah, and you have to pay attention on Ma'am Indri's explanation, because we also have some questions to be answered, and it will be belongs to additional score. So you have to answer by live chat, and then Ma'am Indri will consider it as additional score to your general score, common score.
Yes, that's right. Okay, what about that, ma'am?
It is 37, and I have already asked the student to join by YouTube. We are going to wait, but I think in 2 minutes you have to begin. I'm afraid that we can run out the time because you have explanation and also the question. Sambil yang lainnya tetap ini ya, kontak teman-temannya kalau tidak ada halangan, segera bergabung. Kalau ada halangan, you have to write something on the live chat so we know that maybe you have difficulty in joining us. Mungkin karena listrik mati, mungkin karena kendala laptop atau apa, but we have to know. Kita harus tahu kenapa. Gitu ya. Okay.
And I would like to remind once again, mungkin mau mengingatkan lagi, bahwa semua respon kalian, kalian juga mencantumkan nama dan juga kelas dan nomor akan dicatat, dan itu akan penting untuk score. Jadi once again, ask your friend to join if they cannot join. They just want you.
Ma'am, there is a note from Benedicta Sani. Oh, Benedicta Sani couldn't join the team meet because she has something to do with the family matters. Oh, someone passed away. Thank you very much for joining us.
Please accept my condolences.
Yes, Benedicta. Yeah.
Benedicta, please accept my condolences.
Yes. Oh, I say thank you, Pak Lili, for helping us.
Helping us with the sound. Thank you, Pak Lili. Pak Mas Petrus.
Mas Petrus. And maybe you have to start, ma'am, while okay. I'm helping you to.
Oh, I'm eager to begin my lesson students. Today. Okay, I will. Okay.
Yeah, sorry, it's ma'am. So this longer. Voice is not so
what
louder.
What about this?
Yeah.
Is it okay? Clear enough? Is it clear enough?
Okay. Okay,
okay. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, sister.
Please, Ma'am Indri.
Okay.
Thank you.
But before you start, please explain about the function of the live chat because we are going to have the live chat.
Yes. Girls, students, we have a live chat interaction here. Because why? Because we know that not all of you can join GMIT. Jadi tidak semua bisa gabung di GMIT. So that's why you will have an interaction or active interaction with me and Mem Tias through chat. Both in GMIT and in YouTube, please use the live chat to ask questions or to answer my questions. Atau silakan kalau mau menjawab pertanyaan Mem Indri nanti melalui live chat. Dan jangan lupa, kalian tuliskan nama, kalian tuliskan juga kelas dan nomor. Why? Because I will record your answer or your questions so that you can get extra score for that. Jadi jangan lupa itu ditulis karena Mem Indri akan rekam supaya Mem Indri bisa memberikan extra score atau nilai tambahan untuk semua yang aktif berpartisipasi. Oke, gitu ya.
Are you ready, girls?
Okay, ready?
Yep. Ma'am Indri, please.
If you are ready, I think I have to share something, ma'am.
Yep.
In the screen.
PowerPoint, yeah, yes. On the screen.
Give me that. Ini lari-lari, running. So sorry. Girls, I'd like to share something on my screen. Please pay attention to it and tell me if you cannot see the shared screen, okay? Mm-hmm. Kalau tidak bisa terlihat, silahkan tulis di live chat apa kendala.
Ya. Oke. One of them.
Okay, can you hear? Can you see my shared screen now?
Ya.
Ya, sudah ya. Bisa salah satu mengetik di live chat bagaimana nanti Memtis akan mengecek. Of the lesson today and what is in the wonderful places. Well, we will learn about descriptive text. Like what I have said before, descriptive text is a text that describes something. It can be object, it can be places, it can be anything. Yeah. Jadi, descriptive text adalah teks yang bersifat menggambarkan sesuatu, bisa tempat, bisa objek. Yang penting, sesuatu itu bisa digambarkan oleh kita supaya orang lain mendapatkan informasi yang jelas mengenai objek. Okay. Next. Well, before we begin, Mem Tias, I think I should tell the students the learning map. So that we will not lost somewhere in the middle of the process.
So we know something before we learn.
Yes, that's right. Okay, jadi students, kita akan kalau kita pergi ke tempat wisata tuh kita biasa lihat petanya dulu di depan ya. Jadi kita mau kemana ini, tujuan kita mau kemana. Nah ini mapnya. First, ma'am would like to tell you the reason why we have to learn about descriptive text. Kenapa sih kita harus belajar tentang descriptive text? Like what I've said, at the end of the lesson, students will be able to describe places with the knowledge. So, di akhir pelajaran, kalian diharapkan bisa menggambarkan tempat atau objek dengan pengetahuan yang kalian sudah punyai. Gitu ya. And then, what is the function? Apa sih gunanya kalau kita bisa menggambarkan tempat atau bisa menggambarkan objek? Well, girls, in our daily life, or in our real life, sometimes we want to share our experience to friends, to family, about the places that we have visited. Kadang-kadang kita mau berbagi. Describe the place. If you can describe the object, other people will get important or will get useful information. Penting sekali kalau kita bisa menggambarkan, orang lain yang mendengarkan akan mendapatkan gambaran yang jelas. Ya. And sharing experience cannot be separated from description. Jadi kalau kalian itu punya pengalaman dan sharing pengalaman, apalagi itu pengalaman dengan orang-orang berbahasa Inggris ya, itu sharing pengalaman itu tidak bisa dipisahkan dari menggambarkan sesuatu. Okay? So that's it. Yeah. The reason why we learn this and what is the function of being able to describe. And then, ma'am, what we will learn when we talk about descriptive text. Lalu kita bicara apa sih, belajar apa sih kalau kita bicara tentang descriptive text? Well, of course, we will talk about the language features and the text structure. Pasti kita akan bicara tentang unsur-unsur kebahasaan atau tata bahasanya dan struktur teksnya. And how can we learn that? Well, today, Mem Indri and Mem Tias will bring you to a kind of learning experience to describe something with the language features. Jadi nanti fokus kita hari ini tuh ada di bagian C. We learned about adjectives, noun phrase, adverbs, verbs, and so on that is needed to describe something. Jadi kita akan belajar tentang unsur kebahasaan descriptive text yang kalian butuhkan nanti kalau mau mendeskripsikan sesuatu, ya, itu mereka bisa berupa adjectives, noun phrase, adverbs, verbs, and so on.
What are these words in Indonesia?
Mem Tias, thank you. What is adjectives? Kita belajar apa sih? Adjectives itu apa? Maybe most of you have known adjectives in Indonesian is kata sifat. And then noun phrase in Indonesian means frasa kata benda. I will talk about it later. Adverbs, kata keterangan. Verbs, kata kerja. Yeah, so you can imagine that today we will talk about it. Adjectives, kata sifat, frasa kata benda, kata keterangan, and then also kata kerja dan yang lain-lain. Nanti akan ada yang akan Mem Indri sampaikan. Next, next week, and then at the end of the lesson, there will be learning about text structure, but I will talk about it later. Itu untuk materi berikutnya ya, struktur teksnya bagaimana. Kita belajarnya melalui aktivitas reading, listening, dan membuat teks, composing text. Okay? Lalu tentu saja ada assessment or penilaian. Penilaiannya bagaimana? Like what I've said, seperti yang tadi sudah Mem Indri sampaikan, participation. Nah, participation berarti kalian harus berpartisipasi. Nggak berpartisipasi, ya nilainya nanti poor. Okay? And then you will join the quiz, the exam, performance, and also task or assignment. Okay? Yeah. Ma'am, is there any questions that
not yet.
It's sent by students? No, not yet.
Yeah, oh, not okay. Yet. So you can continue.
Okay, thank you. Now, this is the map, okay? Let's see. Ah, man. Uh-huh. We beautiful have eight places. Beautiful pictures here. Okay. Are you ready, girls? I will ask you few questions about it. Okay. Do you know these places? Okay. Do you know?
Sorry, ma'am.
Huh? Okay.
The presentation. It's we cannot see it.
You cannot see it?
No.
Oh, yes, the presentation.
Yeah. What about the other students?
I can see it.
There's nothing problem on it.
There's no problem.
Oh, there's a problem. Okay.
And I will ask it to the students in the Google, okay. In the YouTube.
Yes, we will stop here. I mean, kita berhenti sejenak di sini dulu sambil menunggu ya. Menunggu teman-teman lain yang mungkin ada sedikit trouble dengan
is there any student who can see the pictures? Adakah yang bisa melihat gambar yang Mem Indri share?
Yes.
That yes, I can see the screen, ma'am. So what's wrong actually?
Oh, I see.
Some students can see the screen and
some
students,
others can see.
Yeah,
it.
There are more than 5 students who said that they can see the screen.
Are you all of you are all of you cannot you. See the pictures or only some students? Let me know.
Yeah, I have more than 10 students, 15 students maybe. He said that they can see it. Mereka bisa. Berarti mungkin ada kendala sinyal ya.
Yeah.
Coba di please move your
gadget
chair
or
to
table,
your gadget
yes,
to other places. Agak berpindah tempat. Karena kadang dengan berpindah tempat nanti screen-nya akan terlihat. So don't worry about it ya. Yeah? And Ma'am Indri, due to this problem, maybe you can also attach the PPT on the GC later on.
Of course. Yeah. Don't worry. Yeah. For students who cannot see my
screen,
my materials in the slides, don't worry. I will send the slides later so that every one of you will be able to learn it.
Yeah.
Nah, nanti Mem Indri pasti akan seperti biasanya akan share setelah Mem Indri jelaskan, akan Mem Indri share supaya kalian bisa download dan bisa mempelajari materi-materi itu.
And don't worry, the YouTube is also recorded.
Yes.
So after this, you are going to see this YouTube again.
Jadi YouTube-nya juga direkam, live streaming-nya direkam, jadi kalian bisa sewaktu-waktu membuka kembali tayangan lalu mempelajari lagi slide-slide-nya. Oke.
Okay? Thank you for informing us, yeah?
Yes, thank you for letting us know.
Yeah.
Maybe some of you have troubles in internet connection, so some of you, I hope that every one of you can access actually, but some of you may be, well, too bad.
Yeah.
Yes, of course, you cannot respond my questions. Well, for those who can see the pictures and also who can respond my questions, please choose one of the picture that you know well and then answer through the live chat. Where is the place? I mean, do you know the location or do you know the name of the places? Yeah, write the location of these pictures in the live chat.
Okay. How long time do they
have? We have to get, yes, 30 seconds is it
30
enough?
Seconds
30
enough?
Seconds is enough.
Yeah.
We will count to 30 seconds, okay? You
and
can begin right now.
Repeat the question first, ma'am.
Okay, it is written there, ma'am. Write the location of these pictures in the live chat.
Okay, go.
Yes.
We are going to record. Yeah, already there are some students.
Oh, good. There are some students have answered the questions. Wow.
Sonia.
Oh, wow. Yes.
Thank
go
you.
On. Yeah, the students. Choose only one. Choose only one picture.
One only. Renata. That's good.
Yes.
Yeah, whether it is right or wrong.
Yes.
It is okay as long as you are brave to answer
the question. Okay.
The question.
Yes.
We are going to talk about it later. Lucia, Mutia, there are so many students, ma'am.
Oh.
Answer the question.
Yes,
30
seconds.
Don't forget, ma'am. It is only 30
right.
seconds.
Have we been in 30 seconds, ma'am?
Wait for 5 seconds.
Okay. Calm down.
Three, two, one.
Okay. Stop. Yeah. Okay. Yes. Let's see about the answers. Ma'am, can you read out loud the answers?
Yep. The answer of the students, I take some of them.
Okay.
Okay, this is from Anna, 10BB.
Oh, Anna, 10BB, yes.
She chose number one.
Number one, okay.
Fuji Mountain.
Oh, that's Japan. Correct.
Is
that's
that right,
correct.
Ma'am?
Yes, it's correct.
Good.
It's...
And I'm going to take another one.
Okay.
From Marcella. Oh, no. Already deleted.
Oh,
Adele. The same answer. Fuji, Adele.
Okay, number one.
And the second from Lucia.
From Lucia.
The second picture is Taj Mahal.
Oh, that's correct.
India.
Yes,
correct?
That's right. Taj Mahal in India. Okay, very good.
And I think they choose Fuji and also Taj Mahal.
Okay.
These two pictures are familiar for them, I think.
Okay, yes, because they are so popular. They are so well known, yeah?
Yeah, there are more than 9 students answer the same. And yeah, Fuji and Taj Mahal.
Okay.
What about the others?
What about the others? Number 3, do you know number 3?
Or maybe number 7, ma'am?
Number seven is yes, the most interesting thing for us, number 7, because it's close to us, very close to us in Yogyakarta. It's located in Yogyakarta.
The student in the Jimit, do you know number 7?
Jimit. Okay, let's see.
Wait.
I think I should. Oh, sorry. Sorry.
Oh, this one.
I cannot see the.
Yeah, it is so
I found
small.
I was looking for the picture. Okay.
Going on.
Yes. What about number 3, ma'am? Do you know the answer?
What is it? This is pyramid.
Pyramid. Where is it?
Is it Egypt, ma'am?
Yes, it's in Egypt. Number 4.
Number
some
4.
Of the students must be familiar with this.
Is it from
Korea? Pasti udah sangat banyak yang tahu. Yes, that's right. It's in Korea, but I don't know how to read the name of the palace.
Yes.
But this is in Korea.
This is the palace.
Yes, this is a very well-known palace, very famous palace in Korea, but I don't know how to read it.
In front of this palace.
Okay. And then I'm not a big fan of Korean movies.
I know.
What about you?
I know.
You are.
I do the same.
You are the big fan of Korean movies, so you must know that. Next, number 5.
Number five is
in Indonesia. Yes, that's correct. In Papua, this is Raja Ampat, the most
beautiful
scenery. Yes, and I heard that this is very.
We have to go to there.
Oh, I mean, okay, someday. Next, number 6.
I don't have any idea about the 6.
The students from Surabaya must know it.
Yep.
Because this is Bambu Runcing Monument in Surabaya. This is the iconic place in Surabaya. Okay. And then number 7, of course, the student from Yogyakarta. This is Breksi Cliff.
Yep.
Tebing Breksi. Yes, in east ward of Yogyakarta, di sebelah timur Yogyakarta. This is near our teacher's house.
Yep.
Okay.
There are so many teachers.
Yes. Next, ma'am.
Number eight is. Is it in Bali, ma'am?
Yes, this is Uluwatu Temple. Okay. Let's continue. Okay. Now, these are the adjectives, the list of the adjective words in English. Oh, I'm afraid that the green one and the yellow one is difficult to read. What do you think?
Wait. In the YouTube it is okay, ma'am.
It's okay. Okay.
It is okay. But you have to read it to make
yes,
sure.
Yes, I will read the list from the top left corner square. Okay. Amazing. And then from the gray one, okay? From the gray one, the gray square. Amazing, exotic, scary, awful. And then the blue one, pleasant, magnificent, well-known, outstanding. And then the yellow one, interesting, horrible, horrible with double R, yeah? Horrible, magical, eye-catching.
What is the meaning of eye-catching, ma'am?
We give the meaning of the words for the leave it for the students to answer, or should I answer it? I don't know. Maybe time is running.
The student will answer. Yes. They can say something, right?
Yes. The students in YouTube and Jimit, you can directly, what is that? Answer. Write down, answer the meaning of the words in Indonesian. Jadi kalau udah tahu artinya, pilih saja. Saya kasih contoh cara jawabnya ya. I will give you the examples of how to answer the questions. You can try to answer the questions. Do you know the meaning of these words in Indonesian? This is the examples.
Yep.
You can look at this. You can write down the words and then equals and then the meaning of the words in Indonesian, and then your name, your class, and your student number. So you can answer in this kind, in this way of answering questions. Okay?
So they can choose any adjectives.
Yes, they can choose only one word.
Only one.
And then give us the meaning of the word in Indonesian.
Yeah.
You only have 1 minute, and after that, I close the session. I mean, the question of answering the questions.
Yeah.
Saya kasih waktu 1 menit aja. Silahkan ada yang coba jawab arti katanya.
Boleh lewat live chat ya.
Live chat, baik Jimit maupun yang YouTube, itu akan kita catat. Siapa yang berusaha menjawab akan dapat extra score.
Who wants to have additional score? Choose one of the adjective and then answer like what Ma'am Indri gave the examples before.
Yeah,
okay, please.
Right. Yang pingin mempertahankan nilai bagus, yang kemarin merasa aduh kuisku yang kemarin belum bisa iya lompat KKM, silahkan dicoba, please. Yeah. Go on.
Yeah, try. Answer the questions. Only the meaning of one word.
Yes.
Cuma saja.
Brown or red?
Huge?
Yeah, red. Huge, overpopulated, historical, luxurious. Okay, girls, you can try to answer the questions only in 1 minute. Only in 1 minute.
Only 1 minute, starting from now. Dimulai dari sekarang. Please go. Choose one word and find the meaning. Go, go. Belum nih, belum ada yang di YouTube. Segera. Kayak tadi.
Yang Jimit nanti dia akan dicatat,
ya,
catat
yang
semua.
Juga. Wow, ma'am, it is already 109. Sambil kita menunggu ya.
Ya.
Yap. Oke. Mari, yang tadi sudah jawab, boleh jawab lagi. Ya?
Boleh jawab lagi ya. Yang ingin meningkatkan skor. Ya. You want to increase the score. Go on, try it.
Yap.
It's very easy. Tulis bahasa Inggrisnya dulu sama dengan apa. Lalu jangan lupa tulis nama, kelas, dan nomor presensi. Oke, okay, what? It's very, very easy.
Yep.
Well known, you must know the meaning of it. Magical, horrible, famous, scary, exotic. Boleh, boleh sambil buka kamus?
Yep.
Boleh loh ya, boleh. In few seconds.
Find the technical problem.
Okay, some students are trying to answer the questions. That's good. Yes, go on. Kita ada sedikit problems, tapi bisa bisa dihandle. Ya, kita akan terus mencoba menjawab. Ma'am, itu sudah 1 menit?
Already.
Already, ya. Yeah. I close. I will see the record. Some students who try to answer the question. Okay, kita lihat ya, sama-sama. Ini ada amazing, itu luar biasa, exotic to exotic. Tidak ada terjemahan secara khusus dalam bahasa Indonesia untuk exotic ya. So we just simply call it exotic. Scary, scary mean, what is that? Menakutkan?
Scary, menakutkan.
Menakutkan. Awful. Awful is, well, ya mengerikan juga ya, mengerikan. Pleasant, menyenangkan. Interesting, menarik. Expensive, mahal. Huge, sangat besar. It's not only big, but it's bigger. Yeah, huge, very huge. Magnificent, luar biasa. Yeah, it's similar with amazing. Horrible, mengerikan. Sama ya dengan awful. Famous, terkenal. Overpopulated, padat. Ya, padat, padat penduduk maksudnya ya.
Ah, Ma'am Indri, maybe because I had the technical problem and now the response come out.
Oh, yes, I see. I know that. I'm sure that everyone is trying to answer the questions.
Can I read some of them?
Yes, of course.
Tiny is mungil. That is Celine, ya.
Celine, oh, that's okay. Correct, Celine.
And also magnificent, luar biasa.
Luar biasa, that's correct.
And this one from Shara. And also, they are very fast. Therefore, it is running.
Oh, running. Thank you. You are so responsive.
Wow.
Yes.
Yep. And well known, terkenal from Elaine.
Oh,
there are so
Elaine.
Many other
so many,
answers.
Yeah, thank you very
I
much.
Read it one
you
by
are
one.
So great and responsive and active students. Wow, that's
thank
great.
You.
Yeah. Siswi kelas 10 luar biasa banget ini responsive banget, ya. Yeah?
Can we stop now? Because
yes, of course.
Are,
yeah. Stop. Because
we
time is running.
Having other exercise.
Okay.
We are still having other exercise.
Now, what is the use of those adjectives, ma'am? These adjectives is very important and very useful to describe the places.
Okay.
I will continue to the next slide. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, you have known the object or the places, and then you have known the meaning of some adjectives. Ya, kita sudah punya modal tempat nih, ini gambar tempatnya, dan sudah punya modal kata sifat yang sudah kita pelajari, ya kan? Nah, next 1 menit lagi ya, siap-siap ya. One more minute.
I have to ask the student to stop first.
Yes.
Okay.
you may stop. Time is up, ya.
Yeah, time is
kita
up.
Kita ganti. We were changing to next exercise.
We have another activity.
Activity. Now, okay. Ready,
ready
ya. What do you think about the places? Bagaimana pendapatmu mengenai tempat-tempat ini? Okay. Write a sentence to describe. Nah, tulis kalimat yang mendeskripsikan the impression, kesan. The impression of the place, kesanmu terhadap tempat ini. Nah, do as the examples. I'll give you the examples.
Yeah, always.
Like this. For example, you choose picture number 2. So you write down 2 and then it is exotic.
It means Taj Mahal or
yeah, Taj Mahal. You may say Taj Mahal is exotic. Okay. You may write time is limited, ma'am, so I cannot write Taj Mahal. I will write it simply. It's okay. The place, you choose number 5, so it means you write down number 5, and then the place is amazing. You choose picture number 1, it means you write down number 1, and then the museum is scary. For example, this is only for examples. Okay? Now,
ready.
Let's begin, ma'am. Yeah, shall
yes.
we? Okay, 1 minute from now. Please do that.
Okay. Choose one picture.
Some students, okay.
And then you
wait,
have
some students are.
Already?
Yes, some students
okay, good,
are trying to
and this
write.
One is also. Oh, very good. There
very
are so
good.
Many
oh
answers.
Oh my God.
Oh, good.
You
girls.
Are so responsive. Look at this. Many
oh,
students are.
It runs very fast.
Yes, they are
good,
so clever, so smart.
They use it looks very peaceful. Oh, very
my
good.
God, this is very advanced sentence, yeah?
Good.
Very good. Okay, wow. There are so many.
Oh, I see the name of the Korean building. Gyeongbokgung.
Gyeongbokgung. Gyeongsamtung.
Thank you for the knowledge that you gave to us. Yeah.
Okay.
The pyramids are very eye-catching. Good, I think. Yeah.
Is it 1 minute already?
Not yet.
Okay, 15 seconds. 15 seconds
left.
Okay. Wow, so many students are answering the questions.
It is difficult to read.
Okay.
The mountain is eye-catching. Raja Ampat is so outstanding.
Wow.
Oh, very good.
Wow. Wow, so many students here.
Yes.
How many seconds?
Done.
Okay, done. Stop. Okay, stop, girls.
Okay,
I will go to the next slides.
Thank you for your response. This is so good.
Yes, very responsive.
They listen to you, ma'am.
Yes, they have understood. Now, students, you can describe the places or the object in a more advanced sentence. Jadi kita sekarang belajar bikin kalimat yang lebih advance ya. Pakai apa? Pakai noun phrase atau frasa kata benda kalau dalam bahasa Indonesia. What is noun phrase? Noun phrase is a group of words to describe an object. Jadi itu sekelompok kata, segerombolan kata. Ya, yang terdiri dari consist of determiner, adjective, and noun. Ya, jadi a group of words to describe object. Jadi menggambarkan satu objek tapi bisa dengan sekelompok kata.
Yeah.
Itu lebih advance ya. Maybe some of you will ask me, what is the determiner? Okay, we'll talk about it in the next slide. Okay. Nah, this is noun phrase. The word of noun phrase. Ini dunia noun phrase itu ini. Determiner in what is that in English, we call determiner is like this: a, an, the, some, several,
few,
a little, five, one, ten. So determiner is usually giving us information about the amount of the object, maybe, or maybe like what is that, to show that this is definite. Nah, itu sudah tertentu ya dengan kata the itu ya. This is determiner. Next, the noun phrase itself. The noun phrase. Yes.
Maybe we can stop for a while for our Angelus prayer.
Yes, sister.
We have to stop
for a while for the Angelus. Okay, students. Let's say a prayer.
I'm going to prepare.
Shall we be waiting for the what is that? The
smoke. Already.
Sabda sudah menjadi daging dan benar di antara kita. Dalam marilah mengalami Tuhan siapa silam kau di antara
kami yang berdosa sekarang dan waktu kami mati. Amin.
Doakanlah kami
supaya kami dapat menikmati janji Kristus. Semoga hati kami bernyala-nyala karena cinta. Buatlah kami cakap dalam pengabdian, tapi tidaklah bermanfaat bagi kami saja, dan juga bagi keselamatan sama manusia. Dan Putra dan Roh Kudus. Amin.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, yeah. Sister.
Welcome.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. Let's continue. This is the noun phrase. We have known what determiner is, and then noun phrase or frasa kata benda is used to describe a certain object or a certain place with the group of words. And the group of words are adjectives, group of adjectives, and noun itself. Jadi, frasa kata benda itu adalah sekelompok kata yang mungkin terdiri dari beberapa kata sifat untuk menerangkan benda yang kita gambarkan itu. Okay, so how can you say that, ma'am, in Indonesian?
Apa ya? Frasa kata benda.
Okay. Yeah. In English, noun phrase follow certain word order. So you cannot write down or you cannot tell the people the noun phrase to describe something with the order that, yeah, in your favor. Suka-suka kamu tuh nggak bisa gitu. It should follow certain rules. It's different from Indonesian. Kalau di Indonesia kita bisa menggambarkan benda itu dengan urutan kata sifatnya terserah kita. But in English you cannot do that. You have to follow certain rules. And here are the rules. After determiner, frasa kata benda or noun phrase usually begins with opinion. This is the example. If I want to say lukisan Spanyol, lukisan tua Spanyol yang luar biasa, atau sebuah lukisan yang berasal dari Spanyol yang sudah tua dan luar biasa, I can say that in English in simplest way by using the noun phrase, like an amazing old Spanish painting. Ini kurang I ya, painting, not painting. Different meaning, but it's okay, it's misspelling. The flawless rounded wooden dining table. Jadi kalau saya mau menyampaikan, if I want to say meja makan terbuat dari kayu berbentuk bulat yang sempurna, I will say that in English is the following: the flawless rounded wooden dining table. And the order dan urutan of the adjectives, kata sifatnya, should follow these rules. Jadi harus seperti ini. Gak boleh rounded itu mendahului flawless. Dining cannot precede wooden, and rounded cannot be placed behind dining or between dining and table. Okay, so it's a bit it's a bit strict, okay? But I think this is not really difficult to memorize.
We have to follow the rules.
Yes, we have to follow the rules. And then another example: some poor small white kintamani puppies. It means in Indonesian, beberapa anjing kecil kintamani berwarna putih atau beberapa anjing kecil kintamani putih yang beberapa anak anjing kintamani putih yang kecil dan malang. That's in Indonesian, it's translated like that. But in English, you have to follow this rule. Some poor, small, white kintamani puppies. In Indonesian, we can say, beberapa anak anjing kintamani yang malang dan berwarna putih serta kecil. Boleh. Atau beberapa anjing, anak anjing malang, beberapa anak anjing kintamani malang yang kecil dan putih. It's up to you. You can do whatever you like, but in English you cannot do that.
And why the box is green, ma'am?
Oh, I see. Yeah, I remember. The green box means this is very subjective. It is opinion, subjective opinion. Mengapa memberi kasih warna hijau? Karena ini sifatnya objektif. Subjektif. Jadi sesuai dengan pendapat yang mengatakan. But the blue ones are the objective atau or fact. Ya, jadi yang biru itu adalah fakta. Umurnya sudah tua, fakta. Spanish buatan Spanyol, fakta. benda pasti fakta ya. Rounded, bentuknya bulat itu fakta. Tapi flawless, sempurna itu menurut saya sempurna, menurut orang lain mungkin tidak sempurna. Malang, malang menurut saya, menurut anak anjingnya sendiri dia nggak merasa malang, ya kan? Small, small itu memang kecil ukurannya. Jadi ada perbandingan. Jadi yang biru ini adalah yang bersifat objektif atau fakta. Nah, yang hijau ini yang subjektif. Dan urutannya seperti ini. Ma'am, if I cannot remember, what can we do? Kalau kita nggak bisa ngapalin urutannya gimana?
Find a way to memorize.
Yes, kita akan cari.
The this, order.
Yes, that's this right. This is what I did when I was a student. Yeah. I make an abbreviation. Ma'am, ini tuh bikin singkatan waktu jadi murid. Bentar, nih. Cara ngapalinnya. Small trick. Opsi agape color matpurno. Opsi means union. C size. Agape itu dari age and shape. Color itu dari color and origin. Mat material, material bahan. Purpose and noun. Purno. Purpose and noun. Opinion itu mulai dari opini tadi ya, pendapat mengenai benda itu. Lalu diikuti dengan ukuran benda. Jadi setelah memberikan pendapat baru muncul ukuran. Age itu usia. Shape bentuknya. Color warna. Origin aslinya atau asalnya dari mana? Dari Bantul, dari Inggris, dari yes. Material bahannya dari apa? Dari kayu, dari kain, dari besi, iron, cloth. Purpose, tujuannya benda itu dibuat untuk apa? Misalnya dining table. Shopping bag. Berarti tas untuk shopping, belanja. Yeah. Dining table
untuk makan.
Meja untuk makan. Meeting room, ruangan untuk pertemuan. Nah, gitu ya. Jadi nggak bisa kita memakai, you cannot say, oh, this is the beautiful meeting bamboo house. Nah, itu nggak bisa. Jadi, this is the beautiful bamboo meeting house. Nah, harus begitu. Jadi, urutannya nggak boleh berubah-berubah.
Harus seperti itu ya.
Yes. This is the abbreviation that I have made, but you can make yourself to help you to memorize the order. You can create your own abbreviation or strategy.
Right.
Ya, jadi sekali lagi, silahkan nanti disingkat-singkat sendiri. Hafal.
Yeah, hafal.
Okay. Nah, this is the last. I think this is the last part. We have to be quick karena ternyata banyak sekali. This is the use of noun phrase to describe places. I'm running. Time is running. You have learned about adjective, so you have been able to describe things like Borobudur is amazing. Tadi sudah dilakukan. You have done that in the beginning of the lesson. And then noun phrase. Borobudur is an amazing Buddhist temple. This is noun phrase. An amazing opinion. Buddhist is like purpose ya, temple. Jadi
tujuan.
Ya, itu candi untuk orang-orang Buddha maksudnya, dibuat oleh dengan tujuan untuk religion ya. Yang amazing gitu. And then contoh lebih lanjut yang advance, the more advanced examples. We use or we describe the places using noun phrase and adverb. Adverb is kata keterangan. Borobudur is a very amazing Buddhist temple. Adverbnya di mana, ma'am?
Very.
Yeah, very. Borobudur is such an amazing stone building in Indonesia. Noun phrase, the adverb. What is that? Yes, it's rich. Yeah, it's getting rich in.
Yeah.
And describe description. More complicated. And then Borobudur is located near Magelang. This is verb. Passive, ya. Terletak di Magelang, Central Java adverb. It is such an amazing stone building and a very famous historical place. If you are able to describe places in more complicated way, kalau kalian bisa menggambarkan apa tempat dengan cara yang lebih advance dengan adjective, with noun phrases, with adverb, with verb, then your description will be more interesting. That's right. Will be attractive. People will get clearer view, clearer description about the place. Okay, people regard it as the biggest Buddhist temple in the world.
Complicated.
Yes, it's more complicated. Okay.
Who knows that someday you will be a journalist, you have to explain something to get the attraction of the reader, so you have to explain in detailed way.
Yes, that's right, that's correct. Okay. Maybe, is there anyone to ask questions?
No, I know the question, any questions, it seems that they have already understand.
Yes,
because they can simple as a place.
Ah, we have come to the end of the lesson. Thank you, girls. Yeah. For the assessment, this is what I will announce to you about the quiz. For the assessment, please visit the Google Classroom and do the quiz for about 15 minutes. So after this, when I have closed the session in live streamingly, you go to Google Classroom and then open the assignments in English. You can write down your name and your class and student number for the attendance list before you do the G-form quiz. Jadi setelah Mem Indri tutup sesi siang ini, kalian bisa langsung masuk ke Google Classroom, lihat tugas bahasa Inggrisnya, penugasan di bahasa Inggris. Jangan lupa tulis nama kelas, nomor presensi, lalu langsung please directly jump into the G-form.
Thank you very much, students, for your cooperation today. So we have 105 students at the YouTube and also 100 students at the Teamit. 106 is and down. But I think you are all good, you are all great. Thank you very much. And you can ask questions to us by WhatsApp. Continued by WhatsApp later after the activity.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
and
that's right.
Maybe Sister Yeti would like to say something.
Yes, Sister. Would you like to?
Would you like to say add something, Sister?
Thank you, Mem Indri and Mem Tias.
Yep.
You look like a twin.
Oh, we are so sure.
But I think this is a good idea when you teach eight classes with two teachers. It's more attractive and more noisy, etc. And the students also can, what you call, can answer.
Yes. The students are great.
Yes. Wow. They are really good to answer the question.
Yes.
And so many thanks for all of you, especially for the students who are active to participate in answer the question.
Yes.
I hope you can continue and improve your lecture. I think it's good to have idea two teachers for eight classes.
thank you very much, sister.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
One note.
Yep.
Don't forget about the character. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can give clue for the last. To mention about the character where you found during the process, for example, confidence from the students or responsibility of the students to answer, etc.
Yes,
thank you.
Maybe the clue for the student so they can improve again their character.
Yep.
Yes.
Thank
you. Okay. Thank you very much.
And
thank you for all students.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And students said, thank you for your lesson, ma'am. We agree. Yes.
Oh, I
thank
see.
You.
Thank you. Thank you, too. Yeah. You are such a great student because, very active and
they are
so
very
responsive.
Brave.
Yes, very brave.
Next
and very
time,
smart.
We still have some classes like this, so
yes.
they can join us.
Yes.
Okay, go to the Google Classroom.
Google Classroom
thank
quickly.
You
thank you for your participation. And don't forget to submit the quiz. Not later than the deadline.
Yeah.
Okay.
MTS and Mem Indri would like to ask permission. Have a nice day to leave. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. You're welcome. Welcome. I'd like to
record. Yeah. Oh, record. Kita ngerekam dulu. Rekam yang sudah jawab. Boleh
di-clip nggak, Pak? Sudah. Terima kasih, Suster.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Yes. Good.
Ngapainnya gimana, Pak?
Tadi.
Oh, dari atas ke bawah,
ke bawah atau dari bawah ke atas?
Ini?
Ya.
Scroll. Banyak banget.
Oh. Kan ini banyak yang ada.
Terus? Copy. Pindah nih. Tadi kayaknya aku punya.
Ya.
Oh, anakku di sini.
Ini tak save kan di tempatku dulu.
Hah? Buka aplikasi yang mana ini?
Dari cari itu dari search ini. Word itu bisa.
Wordpad.
Oh, enggak ya, yang kirinya ya.
Mana?
Word, bawah, Word. Nah, ini.
Oh, ini dia.
Ini tak copy ke Word Mas Indri ya.
Bantu ini ya.
Ya, komen. Oh. Ternyata mereka interaktif loh, Pak Agus. Mereka ini sampai 11 halaman nih yang jawab. Oh. Sampai ini. 11 halaman.
Oh, ini banyak banget. Oh, ini juga.
Yang YouTube sampai 11.
Terus men. Ini tayang save as atau gimana, Pak? Oh, di YouTube-nya tak. Plus
juga. Bapak ngerekstrak.
Ini.
Master. Mas Pat butuh pembicara lagi nggak? Kita semakin lama semakin itu loh, Mas.
Thank you very much for those who have participated. Thank you for Mem Tias, Sister Yeti. Thank you for the TIK team, Pak Lili, Pak Agus, Mas Petrus. Ada yang berdengung.
You're welcome.
So much. And this is great. This is a great team, sister. Very much.
Yeah, I think it's good collaboration also.
Yes, ma'am. Sister, saya pameri gelasnya ya, sister. Ini.
Iya, makanya I show the glasses.
Kemarin diminta bisa kalau podcast pakai gelas sih.
Yeah. Okay. But I don't know in my screen is not so bright.
So bright. Oh, maybe
your light. Screen. Maybe it's about the light.
Yes. Bulina and Butias.
Okay.
Thank you, sister.
Thank you very much.